Hello everyone. Welcome to the market simulation call for summer 2021 release. My name is Anshuman Vaidya. I'm your market simulation coordinator, and today is June 17th. Calls and webinars are recorded for stakeholder convenience, allowing those who are unable to attend to listen to the recordings after the meetings. The recordings will be publicly available on the ISO webpage for a limited time following the meetings. The recordings and any related transcription should not be reprinted without the ISO permission. So we have the following agenda today. We'll talk about MapStage availability. We'll talk about the remaining market simulation initiatives and timelines. We'll talk about the remaining initiatives separately. Then we'll talk about known issues and a quick reminder about the system interface changes that are coming up with the summer release and next steps. You can always log into portalmap.kaiso.com for up-to-date map stage availability information. Currently, we have a maintenance for OMS UI and API from 624 to 628. And there's a cyber UI API maintenance on 625. It's tentative right now. Any questions regarding map stage availability? All right, moving on.
Hi, Instrument, sorry, I'm a little late for unmute myself. This is Chunyu. So the potential outage or the maintenance for the cyber on Friday, is that gonna be in the morning or afternoon, or it's gonna be after the testing?
So I don't think we have decided on that yet, but let me invite Triang to give us an update on that one.
Hey, thanks for the question. So I echo what Andrewman said, we haven't decided yet, but we have it on here for discussion. So if there's a preference, then we're happy to take that back and schedule around that. Chunyu, is there a preference from your side?
Yeah, I think as I sent an email to you guys earlier that we will be really very much want to have the next week to continue to test the SOC, especially we have been getting success for the for today, and we're not sure about tomorrow. So it will be really good to know that that it's in place. But so if we come to June 24th and we know we did really well, and maybe we can notify Kaiso, but otherwise we will pretty much like to reserve the environment for testing. Thank you.
All right, that sounds good. We'll leave it on the agenda and touch base at each of the markets and calls as we get closer to continue to coordinate on that schedule for the cyber maintenance.
Great, thank you.
Thanks.
Perfect, any other questions for the map stage availability?
Right. I just did to add just one other comment, just for context around the OMS and cyber change too. As we list on the interface change summaries, I just wanted to give context again, a reminder of what these changes are. For OMS, that maintenance is going to be for the remaining RA changes. There's 4 items there and then 1 item for OSI to support the 628 start of the market sim for those features. And then for cyber, the 625 maintenance is in support of the last phase of the summer readiness market sim, which has a start date of June 30. Okay. Okay. Thanks, Andrew.
Thank you, Triang, for the update. Any questions on the update that Triang just gave? All right, moving on. So we have the following timelines. We have received QRB approval for market sim for resource adequacy enhancements track 1 phase 2 and summer 2021 readiness phase 3. We will be performing market sim scenarios for both the projects today. Any question? We have opened up the system for market participants to review from 6:14 for summer readiness and on yesterday for resource adequacy enhancements track 1. Anybody has any questions regarding the timelines?
Hi, Prashanti from PG&E. So you said you opened it on 6/14 for summer readiness. You mean, did you release it in production? Because this Sunday we noticed this Sunday we noticed that the CAISO portal, the prod, the production portal, has the latest version of generator RDT and intertie RDT files in it. So I believe you have released that in production as well, production CAISO, the master file changes at least.
Yes, I can take this. Thanks for the question. So for the master file changes for the summer release, those are all implemented in production as of June 10th. So that includes multiple projects and including what you see here. So the details are on the interface slide as well that reflect that. So yes, that is there, and there's still remaining functionality that is yet to be deployed or active in production as part of summer, but all of the summer release file changes are in production.
Thank you, Trey. And just to add more context, currently we are testing phase 3 in map stage for a minimum state of charge functionality. Go ahead.
Trang, so what about the other functionality, storage operating limit? I don't see that still in map stage. Not in
Are you which system are you referring to for that?
The CMRI storage operating limit.
For summer readiness, right?
It was supposed to go live in production June 30. In our last Thursday meeting, you mentioned June 15th, you're going to be releasing it to Maps Stage Portal. The data, at least, just the data. We don't see data yet in Maps Stage.
Okay, thank you for clarifying. Okay, so for the RA reports for the CMRI reports for RA, those changes are in the map stage environment. I'll double check and see when data started to be available, but definitely we prioritize that to have that ready for the market simulation to start today, but I don't know when that data is populated. But I know that we, after we put it in, we did some internal validation with data present. So I'll see what data is there for your connectivity purposes, and then confirm the expectation for when you should see it flow for the market sim starting today.
Okay, thank you, Sean.
Okay, yep, okay, bye.
Hey,
Trent.
Go ahead, Isaac.
Hey, sorry. Just wondering, hey, would it be possible to run the summer readiness scenarios 3 and 4 again next week, the structure scenarios? We may not have put in the bids for today's market sim. I apologize. So if it's possible, can we run the structure scenarios again next? I don't know if there's anything special that you guys need to set up for that, but then I just wanted to ask. In case you do.
I will leave that to Anshuman to respond to. He's more familiar with those ones and the effort associated. Anshuman?
Hi, Isaac. So we can do that next week. Actually, we plan to create those scenarios next week also on MapStage to allow market participants to finish their testing. But for today, we are also settling it. So even though the remaining functionality does not have any settlements impact, so we will settle today's date, but you're more than welcome to test it today, tomorrow, and the whole next week.
Sure. If I submit real-time bids into the system now, will we still see some hours where those settlements outcome will show up on the statement?
I'm sure, yes, if the bids are exactly what we need for the scenario, I'm sure you'll see the results.
I'll give it a shot. Thanks.
Thank you. Any other questions?
Yeah, Anshuman, this is Chen Yu. Just want to follow up on the June 4 statement, settlement statement. I know you mentioned that it's going to take another couple of days. I just want to know if you have any you have any idea when we shall expect that. This is the one for the entitized make-whole payment scenario.
Correct. Thank you for bringing that up, Chinyu. So we are expecting to produce another 6-4 recalc statement by next Tuesday.
By next Tuesday. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
No problem. Any other questions here? All right, moving on. So these are the remaining scenario descriptions that we have for RA enhancements phase 2 and summer readiness phase 3. We'll be testing scenario 4 and 5 for RA enhancement phase 2 and 3 and 4 for summer readiness phase 3 today. Any questions regarding the scenario descriptions? All right, moving on. All right, so for summer readiness 2021 and business adequacy enhancements track 1, we have the following documents listed for business requirements specification and structured scenario documents. So I will recommend if you want to know more about the project, you know, you can go to the resources and learn more about the functionalities. Any questions regarding these two projects?
Hi, Inchman, this is Chen Yu. I do have one more question. So sure. Understand the RDRR portion of the summer readiness phase 2 of the RDPT process has not gone into production yet. So does CAISO have a date, a new target date, or we have to wait till next week to get any information?
I don't have a firm date as of now. Chinyu, go ahead, Trang.
Yeah, no, thanks, Anshuman. Thanks, Chinyu. So our target right now, Chinyu, is to activate the RDRR in RTPD functionality next week. Tentatively, it is Tuesday, the 22nd is what we're planning. I believe we did reflect that in the ROG presentation that was posted on Tuesday. And then we can, you know, provide additional updates. But currently our plan is to have a separate decision for RDRR and RTPD, and our target is by Tuesday for activation, although that's tentative based on our results until then.
Okay, sounds great. And it's in the presentation of the ROC call under summer readiness, you say? That's being reflected?
Yeah, so on Tuesday after the call, I did clarify based on the notes that I took during the RUG and reposted that, including a summary of the summer expectations. There are still additional updates on summer and how the production deployments will happen, but that does have the RDRR target in there.
Thank you. Sounds good.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you, Trang, for the update. Any other questions that we can answer here for those two projects? All right, moving on. This is just a reminder of the OMS summer release timeline. We're still looking forward to opening the OMS environment for the next item, the preventing extension of planned CAISO outage. Any questions regarding this OMS summer release timeline?
Yes, this is Michael Folpe from PG&E. Can you confirm that the overlapping PMAX NGR documentation is available? I think that was an action item from this week's road call.
Anshuman, this is Sandhya. I can take that. I believe we had a conversation, the business had a call and they provided that information already. I can talk to our customer service rep and follow up, but I believe that's already been provided.
Yeah, I was on that call, and there was documentation, but there were not structured scenarios. So I was just wondering, or it wasn't DRS format either.
Okay, because this specific change for the overlapping PMAX outages for battery resources is being covered by the OSI project. And the BRS for that is different from the RAE. The BRS for the OSI project has been posted externally. I'm wondering whether you took a look at that.
Yeah, I don't believe it's been updated with what the conversation we spoke about on Monday with. So I'll need to follow up.
Yes, please. Actually, if you could send us a certificate with your specific questions, we'll take a look at that, because I thought we'd got this covered, but you know, we're happy to take a look at it.
Hi, Sandhya, this is Chen Yu from PG&E, and I'm just opening the OSI BRS. Okay. And I see three items there. I am not sure that doesn't look like it's a full overlapping NGR outage. And another thing I do recall, Michael's right, in last call, we're asking whether there will be structure test scenarios. And I think CAISO was going to follow up on that. So just want to know where we are on that.
I was just going to provide an update as far as the scenarios. We did cover that in the tug call, and we provided the use cases that you would be testing, but Anshuman, do you have anything more to add?
No, I was just going to echo that, and I was going to mention that, you know, if you have missed any more updates that you were expecting, please send us an email, and I'll make sure we follow up and we send you the details that is needed.
Yeah,
okay.
Just a comment on the BRS as well. The version 1.0 of the BRS, when we reviewed it, did not have the overlapping outage, but we reposted a revision. Version 1.1 does have it, and as BRQ 200 listed there, and that's under independent 2021 on the release planning site. So please take a look at that, and if you're looking for more detail or clarification on the BRS, then we'll be happy to review your comments there too.
That's good. Thank you. In terms of the, so now, since Sandhya says the scenario or the test, the use case has been shared, yes, I do recall there are three use cases being shared. So this point, in order to participate in the market sim call, I mean, in the market sim, we still need to provide the NGR resource we are going to participate, right? And Shimon, you're still expecting that?
Yeah, that will definitely be great to have.
Okay. And so, do you have a deadline for that?
I don't have a deadline as of now, but if you have the details, then if you can send it over by the next market sim call, we'll get gather all those details, and we'll make sure that your resources are set up for testing of this project.
Okay. And may I ask, maybe just right before June 28, maybe a week before that, you can, yeah, just communicate out what is required for market participants. If the if some additional information is needed besides the resource registration. Thank you.
Will do. We will provide more information in the next MarketSim call on Monday.
Thanks.
All right, any more questions we can answer here?
I wonder, Anshuman, if maybe we could ask those that are interested in that, do you want customers to maybe send a note to MarketSim about their interest in that piece to prepare better outreach?
That's great comment, Trang, and I'm expecting if you know if interested parties could send an email to marketsim@kaiso.com with their registration details for this particular project and the resources they plan to use. That will be really helpful so that we can gather all the details and you know make sure the resources are present. All right, any other thoughts or concerns regarding this project or the timeline? Okay, moving on. We still have 2 known issues. We are still investigating it internally. I don't have a status that when will the fix will be available for them. I don't have that date yet. Any questions on the known issues? All right, moving on. And this is a quick reminder about the system interface changes and the timeline on when they would be activated in map stage and production. Trang, do we have any update on the interface changes?
Yeah, sure. A few updates here is cyber for summer readiness. The map stage availability date did change to reflect the maintenance of the 25th to have that available by the 28th. So that did shift out a little bit. And then in terms of the RA enhancement CMRI, Chris, if you're still on there, I do have some updates about the data availability for both CMRI and OASIS for RA. In map stage, we do have data available in those reports for trade date the 15th and the 16th. That's what we use for our testing, so you could use that for connectivity, and then I'll follow up on further updates there. And then I think for the tech specs for cyber for FERC 831, those are a little bit delayed right now. We have planned by the end of this month, but due to our you know, focusing on getting summer readiness cyber changes for MarketSim ready, we anticipate to have those tech specs for FERC 831 cyber out in July.
Thank you, Trang, for the update. Any questions here for the system interface changes? All right. I think that's all I had for today's teleconference. The next one is scheduled on June 21st at 2 p.m. I'll open up for any other questions that we can answer here.
Right. Anshuman, sorry. Entering. Sorry, I forget. I missed the last point that Trang made about the cyber tech spec and the CMRI. I mean, for the cyber. Is that for the API piece for the ceiling?
Yeah, exactly. And that is for FERC 831, which again, that data is already live in production and available in the UI. It's just we had an API to come later. And the tech spec, we plan to publish that, I believe it was, but due to our focus on getting summer readiness ready for that last piece of MarketSim for cyber, the tech specs are pushed out a little bit and we plan to publish those in July for the ceiling.
Okay, and but there's no still TBD for the map stage in production, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yep.
Yeah, we would really like to know if you have it there, because right now we have, I mean, we have the information in UI, but because we've been telling our vendor to, first we thought the tech spec coming on the 21st, and in a couple of days of, ago, there was a discussion and we kind of tell our vendor to hold on to not, if there's API coming soon, so we don't want to just pull the data from UI and then do the work that twice. So now, if you're very certain it's going to July, it's going to push to July, it would be really known to ask when it's July and when it's a production and map stage. That way we can cut out, I mean, one is to reduce the double work, or we can, right now we're just manually pulling it and try to store it. So that would be very helpful to know the target for CAISO.
Okay, Chanyu, I understand now, and I appreciate that context and the feedback. So I'll get with the SMEs to try to expedite the, defining that timeline for you to go back and assess with your vendor what direction you want to take. I don't have that right now, but I'll reach out to you and publish that as soon as I can.
That would be great. Thank you.
Yep.
Really appreciate
it. Thank you for
that.
Yep.
Perfect. Any other questions here that we can answer?
Hi, this is Tony Gerard from Power Settlement. Just confirming in the UI that I do see the effective data charge limits for 617. But I have a question on the known issue. We haven't yet got to the API. Should the API work? It just the request doesn't include resource, or I'm not sure I know exactly what the issue is on that report.
Tony, let me send you an email regarding what exactly the issue is for the OSS
okay.
report.
Yeah,
I can send you an email with all the information.
Yeah, great.
Thank you.
You need me to send you an email with my email address?
Sure.
Okay, great. Thanks.
Thank you. All right. Any other questions that we can answer here? All right. Well, thank you everyone for joining the call. We'll see you back again at 2 p.m. on 21st.
Thank you.